In this lesson, we're going to discuss some of the remote capabilities of Linux and of Caldera itself. The first one we want to look at is what's called a VNC, or Virtual Network Computer. Now, what this allows me to do is to look at my remote Caldera computer locally from the Windows or Mac computer that I'm sitting in front of. Now, if we pan out, we'll see that this is actually a window viewed on my Windows 7 computer. What this is great for is if you have your computer that you're designing in one area and want to access your Caldera computer remotely from that's in a different area. If you open up your web browser, you can type in the IP address of your Caldera computer and access what's known as the Caldera web server. This has links to all documentation that they have in PDF format. It has links to the VNC client that we've been using to access our computer remotely, and it has links to upload to a hot folder or just to the public folder of your Caldera computer. Now, if we click on the HTTP link, it'll open up a remote file Dropbox. We can choose a file just by browsing our computer and finding a file, and then click the print button, which will upload it to our Caldera computer. Now, it takes a few moments to process, but once you upload it, it'll come up right to the computer and then show up in the default tab of your default image browser window. Once it's shown up there, you can click and drag it and print it just like any other job. Another easier way to get files to your Caldera computer from a remote computer is by using simple Windows file sharing. By opening up your network browser, you can find your Caldera PC, and in there, there's a public folder. Once you open up that public folder, you'll find your hot folder. And then from there, you can grab any file that you may have on your local Windows computer and just click and drag over. Get these out of the way, and in a moment, you'll see it pop up in our default image browser. Once the file is shown up, just like before, we can just click and drag this to print or throw it in a compose. Speaking of remote file transfer, one of the best uses for this is integrating hot folders into your workflow. A hot folder is used to import a specific file a specific way, to reduce the amount of work at printing time. You can set them up for any reason, but common ones are to separate files based on type or by job or customer. We'll go ahead and create one using a two-step process with a third step just for the specific process that we're doing. The first step that we need to do is create the actual physical folder that we're going to drop these into. Now, the easiest way to do that is to drop those into your public folder. So we're going to go to our home directory and go to public. And in there is where we're going to create our new folder. Now, we can simply right click and hit create folder. We're just going to give this a customer name. We're going to call it John Doe. We're actually going to leave it all one word with no spaces just to make life easier. Now that we've got our John Doe folder, our second step is actually an optional step. What we're going to do is we're going to create a second tab in our image browser just for this jobs for this customer. Right click anywhere in the window and hit new tab. And we're going to call it John Doe. Once we've created a John Doe tab, now we can create a hot folder that's associated with that. What we'll do is we'll go to our special menu. We'll go to hot folders. Now up here you can see all of our existing hot folders, but we're going to click on the new button to add a new hot folder. We're going to call this John Doe. Workflow we're going to leave set as none, and for tab, we're going to put it on the John Doe tab. Now the directory that we're looking at is actually going to be the one we just created, the home file under public, John Doe. Now the reason we're using the public folder is it's already shared out across our network. We don't have to do any additional setup for it. Now once we've chosen that, we've also got this file manager parameters, which pops up the window that's for our file manager. Now this looks pretty similar from the previous video we've done, and you can set up settings just like you would there so that every file that comes in with this hot folder has a specific setup. Once we're set with that, we'll click on our OK button. And now we have our new John Doe hot folder. We'll quit out of there, and we've set up everything. To test out our file transfer, we're just going to do the same thing as we did before by opening up our Caldera drive, and then under public, our John Doe folder is there. We can open it up and then find all the files that we need to drop into there. I've got several files here that I'll copy into, and we'll just copy them across our network to it. now that they've all transferred, and close out our window, we can already see that some of them have already been dropped into our John Doe tab. Our fourth one should appear in just a moment. Now all of our files are located in our Dropbox, we're ready to print them just like we would any other job. That's probably the best way to use these. However, you can always create workflows for types of jobs, whether they be specifically print and cut jobs or jobs that come in from the internet or any other type of job category that you want. Using hot folders is a great way to organize your workflow. Hope these tips have been helpful, and we'll see you next time.